Okay, the friends, I am going to be completely honest with you. I am super nervous to do this video. You guys ask me about calories all the time, but I never want to do videos on them because I am not a doctor, I'm not a dietitian, I'm not anything with papers. Numbers also make my brain go bananas. If you don't know, I have sort of been using a range of calories to lean out recently and I've had some results. So I'm going to share with you from my experience. I'm not a doctor, so just take this with a grain of salt or however you say that. And let's begin. Everyone has been commenting in all of my recent videos that I'm getting leaner and you want to know about calories and what I've been doing to lose the weight. So here's the deal. I have lost 130 pounds and kept it off for over 5 years. But in the summer, there was a little bit of fat that I wanted to get rid of. I thought, you know, I could lean out a little bit. So I decided to get a sort of estimate of what my maintenance calories were and do a small deficit and try to lean out a little bit. I didn't do calories from the beginning because one, for those of you that don't know, I struggled with binge eating disorder most of my life. So anytime I would try to operate within numbers of things, it would just set me off and I would binge again. Numbers just frustrate me. I'm not a math person and it just was too overwhelming. So to lose the 130 pounds, I did portion control. I just looked on the back of serving sizes, nutrition labels. I used the serving sizes on those. And that is how I lost weight, just portioning out my food. But I knew I'd have to be a little more specific to lean out this time. So, because I didn't have much weight to lose. So I went to this. It's, you know, there's tons of calculators online to calculate your calories. Just know none of them are accurate. And I don't put my full life belief into calories or anything like that. It's just an estimate. I just wanted a guide. So I went to this calorie calculator called tdeecalculator.net. There, you type in your weight, your height, your exercise level, and your age, and it gives you a ballpark. So for me, it said, at the time, I was 165 pounds. And it said, for me to maintain, it was about 2,200 calories. If I wanted to lose very fast, like 2 pounds a week or so, that I could eat 1,600 calories. Or if I wanted to lose it a little bit slower, I could do about 1,950 calories. I didn't have a lot of weight to lose, so I chose 1900, and I just rounded it up to 1900. So that's about a calorie deficit of 300 calories a day. So that's what I did. I chose foods that I really liked that were low calorie, low fat, but that filled me up, like popcorn, high fiber foods like berries, and I ate about 1900 calories a day. I didn't get really stuck on it, I just sort of gave it an estimate. In doing that, in 3 months, I lost 20 pounds. I went from a size 10-11 pant to a size 6, and I lost about 6% body fat. So even though I didn't have much weight to lose, I had some body fat to lose. That's, you guys are seeing, that's it. 300 calories a day less, and I went from a 10-11 to a size 6.
And keep in mind, guys, like Nicole, 300 calories a day, what is, could be a lot for someone or it could be not a lot. For yes. Nicole, it was perfect because you've been happy in the 300 calorie deficit, where other people that were much leaner and only trying to lose maybe 2 pounds, 300 calories would be extreme cutting.
Yeah, and at that point, 300 calories was great. I am very... my day is very intense. I work out intense. I do an hour of cardio 6 days a week. 1900 calories a day, eating 300 calories less at 1900 calories a day, that fuels me just enough. I am still really hungry, but I am still looking leaner every day Still, and this is 6 months later now, and I'm still looking leaner every single morning when I wake up. So it's still working for me. At 275 pounds when I was super heavy, 300 calories probably wouldn't have been a big enough deficit. When I had a lot of weight to lose, I needed a much bigger deficit. So like 500 calories or more, and that was how I was losing weight then. So depending on how much weight you have to lose, your deficit is going to look different than mine. Like Kyle said, if you only have a very little bit, it might be, 300 might be too much for you.
Yeah, you might need to just cut 50 calories.
Yes, but if you have a more weight than I did to lose, you might need a bigger deficit.
So we also weight train 4 times a week on top of the 6 days hour cardio.
Yes, and I eat a balanced diet, but I choose low fat, low calorie versions of foods because it allows me to eat more. If you eat higher fat foods, you'll get less food for 1900 calories than you would if you ate lower calorie foods, like popcorn or spinach or berries. When I fill my belly with low calorie dense foods, I feel more full and I feel more satisfied.
We see so many people in the comments and then other YouTubers that are on a weight loss journey that are saying they're starving, they're hungry all the time, and then we see them try keto, or we see them reduce their carbs so drastically that, yeah, they're gonna be hungry, and they're wondering why they're hungry, and they only get, you know, a little bit of peanut butter, or a little, we're eating bowls bigger than Nicole's head full of popcorn and ice cream, protein ice cream, and like low calorie pizzas, tons of fruit, tons of veggies.
And we're able to fuel very intense work days and workout days on that food. If you're in a deficit, we also get this question. I'm in a calorie deficit, but I'm starving. You are gonna be hungry when you're in a deficit and losing weight, but if you might be choosing foods that you only get a little bit of. So if you're choosing nuts over a bag of popcorn, 200 calories of nuts is very little. 200 calories of Smart Pop is like that. So your belly's not gonna really fill up on little nuts. It'll fill up with popcorn. That's what she said. So hopefully that sort of helps. It's when you're in a deficit, choose things you can eat a lot of for less calories.
And also, like, I wanna say, choose a deficit where you can also live with it and be happy and actually see yourself sustaining that deficit for a month or whatever it is you need to do.
That's a great point. That's why I purposely chose to eat 1900 and lose it a little bit slower.
Instead of the 16.
Yes, because I could have lost 30 pounds in like 2 months, but I would have not enjoyed my life.
It's too fast too. You gotta be aware of that. If you're dropping way too fast, you might feel like an all-star at first.
Not gonna stay off.
Yeah, because you're never gonna be able to keep that up.
And because I've been eating the 1900 calories, loving my food, really enjoying what I'm doing, I'm still losing weight. I'm still like, I'm a size 6, but I have a feeling I'm going to be a smaller size very soon because I'm still getting results because I can stay on track. There's no track because I love it. It doesn't feel like a diet.
And guys, don't feel bad if you can't do what Nicole's doing. This is like 7-8 years down the road dieting.
Yeah.
So everyone's body and life is different. If you're in a 300, 500 calorie deficit and you're really struggling, then go slower. It's worth it to go slower.
And that is what I wanted to touch on next. If you cannot handle numbers and you're watching this video, Kyle has also lost 130 pounds and kept it off for over 5 years. In the beginning, we are not numbers people. We couldn't do calories. It really hurt us to do calories. It would just backfire.
We got too obsessed with it, too focused on the numbers.
Yeah. And so we found just eating less, portioning out our food worked better. So look on the back of foods that you buy on the nutrition labels. It gives you serving sizes. That's what we used. And then we kind of just went from there and figured out the serving sizes that worked for us. If that is overwhelming you too, do this. Look at what you're eating for each meal. For example, if you're eating 4 pieces of toast, 5 slices of bacon, and a big banana for breakfast, eat 2 pieces of toast, 2 pieces of bacon, and a small banana. That's it. Just reduce it a little bit.
Exactly.
Just one meal to start.
Like, for instance, you guys know me and Nicole are brutally honest with you. We were eating, like, just example for a snack, a whole bag of big family-sized chips each a night. So what we did at one point is we said, how about we split one bag of chips every night? Don't try to fix everything all at once. Let's just split a bag instead of eating a whole bag.
And we did that for a while until we were comfortable
with it. Yeah.
Then we said, you know what? We can actually eat less than the bag, one bag together. So we got a bowl about that big each and we filled it. And then there was still chips in the bag. And then we were able to put it in the freezer.
Then eventually, weeks later, I don't know exactly how long it was, but we eventually then portioned the chips to the actual portion that serving. It says on the back of the bag.
Which is like 36 chips or something. But going from a bag of chips a day each to 36 chips was way too much. So don't be hard on yourself, because we had to do baby steps. But the thing is, if you can master a small step, then when you're comfortable, move on. Yes, it's going to be slower, but this is why we've been able to keep the weight off for so long, because we took baby steps and let it help us and learn to be okay with it. So if you want to know exactly what we ate to lose our first and next 50 pounds, we actually have 2 weight loss guides, exact portions, exact foods we ate, family-friendly recipes. It's all in there. Check out the links down below.
And no calories in those books at all, because portion. We did not do that to lose the first 50 and the next 50.
Nope, only portion control in those. If you want to see what I eat, check out, you know, the videos. Go to the channel, look at it. I show you everything, literally. It's all there. Go check it out. Thanks for bearing with me. Again, I was nervous, but you made me feel good. So, to friends, I love you. I hope this helps. Don't overwhelm it, just little steps. I love you. And long more. Bye, guys.
Are you done yet?
I can do more.
Okay.
Show them the slippers.
Do the slipper shot.
Get on the couch.
Hey!
Bye, guys. Remember, the friends, that weight loss isn't just about the number on the scale. It's also about here and here. Heart and mindset. Fight through it. You can do it. Don't give up.